In this video, I'm going to show you how to add accessibility features to your Compose app. With a small amount of work, you can increase your app's reach and versatility. Using Jetpack Compose, a lot of accessibility features work out of the box, but in some cases, you'll have to do manual work. Let me walk you through some of those situations. We will use the JetNew sample as a playground area and TalkBack as the accessibility service to test with. Let's start by enabling TalkBack and see how the app behaves when we haven't done any custom accessibility work.
Top stories for you, JetNews. Locale changes in the Android view model anti-pattern, Jose Alcereca, April 2nd, 1 minute read. Double tap to activate. A little thing about Android module paths, Pietro Maggi, 1 minute read. A little thing about Android module paths.
As you can hear, TalkBack does quite a good job interacting with the app without us needing to make any changes. It reads out information on the screen, highlights different parts, and responds to user interaction. Now let's see in which ways we can improve the experience. We will discuss three improvements: labeling visual elements, merging multiple composables, and adding actions to lists. Let's first look at our app's visual elements. In JetNews, you can see multiple icons, a hero image, and an avatar. Without adding some semantic meaning to those elements, accessibility services will not know what to do. Let's see that in action.
Button. Double tap to activate. Button. Double tap to activate.
The icon buttons only pronounce button. The hero image and the avatar are not focusable at all. To fix this, we have to add a content description to these elements. Let's add a content description for the heart icon in the bottom bar. Make sure to use a localized string resource here, as we want our users to hear it in their own language. When we now run the app, TalkBack correctly labels the actions linked to this icon.
Add to favorites button. Double tap to activate.
For each visual in your app, decide whether you want to define a content description. If the visual is purely decorative, you should set the content description to null. Next up, we will look at merging composables. Often, the system handles this for us. For example, contents of a list item or any clickable container have their contents merged, so accessibility services regard them as one element. In some cases, we can manually merge composables to improve the selection behavior of the accessibility service. In our sample, the avatar, author, and metadata of the article are regarded as separate elements and are selected separately.
Pietro Maggi. August 2nd, 1 minute read.
Let's open the class where these composables are being made. To merge them, we'll add a semantics modifier to their parent container and specify merge descendants as true. Now, when we select the container, the elements are read all at once.
Pietro Maggi, August 2nd, 1 minute read.
Finally, let's look at adding custom actions to list items. In the home of our app, each article separately selects the list item and the bookmark icon.
A little thing about Android module. Unchecked, checkbox. Dagger and Kotlin, gotchas and optimization. Unchecked, checkbox. Double tap to toggle.
This is not going to scale well. When we add more and more actions to the list item, TalkBack users will have to swipe a lot to go through each action. To improve this, we can add a custom action to the list item. This is done in three steps. First, we define the name of the action based on the current state. Next, we add semantics modifier and set the custom actions property. Finally, we clear any semantics on the bookmark button itself so it will not gain focus anymore. Let's run this code.
A little thing about Android module paths, Pietro Maggi, 1 minute read. Dagger and Kotlin, gotchas and optimizations, Manuel Vivo, 3 minutes read. Double tap to activate, actions available, you swipe up then right to view. Alert local context menu. Actions, in list. Alert actions. Add to bookmarks, in list. Double tap to activate.
That was an overview of the Jetpack Compose accessibility APIs. To learn more about Jetpack Compose, check out the pathway linked in the description below. Thanks for watching.